Hi folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this third video on event handling with MinIO, we're going to be taking a look at custom webhooks written with the Python programming language. The webhook event destination is what you're going to use if your preferred service that you want to send your stuff to isn't directly available. You can write a webhook, or you can deploy a webhook as an excellent option if your system has a webhook available. For instance, Slack in many cases has these webhooks. You can set up a Slack webhook for this and then connect into that webhook. You can also write your own custom code to handle events with a dedicated service. Now, here's the important part. All of your webhooks that you're going to stand up, they need to be able to connect to a simple queue service. MinIO implements a simple queue service to actually send the events out. And so what we're going to be doing is we're going to be reading from that simple queue service. With that, you can do basically anything that you want. Keep in mind that all of these events are going to be handed out as JSON objects, which you can then parse with any tool that can manage JSON. This is one of the reasons why Elasticsearch and all the databases are really handy, because you have the ability to parse that JSON into whatever format you want. It's really great. So, an event destination, whether it's a webhook or a database or a queue, these are cluster-wide. So you're going to set up your event destination once, and then you can reuse that for many different event notifications from various buckets. So one of the event destination types that we spoke about earlier was this custom webhook. And this allows you to write a event handler in any language that you like. Now, we have a few different programming languages that have MinIO APIs associated with them, makes it a little easier to code with them. Things like Python, Java, .NET, all of these have their own MinIO API that we work on, that we publish. We're going to take a look at using Python to do this webhook. It gives us amazing flexibility to this. Okay, so we can set up this webhook. We can have multiple subscriptions to various different event notifications. We can have separate webhooks for different event types and just register a bunch of different event destinations, right? The only real requirement is that I have to be able to receive events via that simple queue service. Other than that, I'm good to go. For a webhook with Python, it's great. Python is really simple to use. There's no compilation. It's a very easy to understand language. You can read through the code very easily. And then there's this extension to Python called Flask, which allows you to deploy a web service in Python trivially. It's really simple to deploy a Flask-based Python webhook. Plus, since MinIO has this robust SDK for Python, I can use the Flask extensions and the MinIO extensions and develop a really robust webhook without having to spend a lot of time and without having to stand up a whole nother server or service. I just run this on any system that supports Python and I'm good to go. As far as a Flask SQS code example goes, I can literally do exactly this. And if you want to just grab this code and then plonk it into whatever Flask-enabled Python environment you have and deploy this, guess what? Now you have a webhook running on port 9999 that you can subscribe to. All I really need to do is manage the request. I need to get the JSON from the request that comes in. That gives me my payload. And I need to make sure I'm returning this JSONify payload. Okay, this is part of SQS. I want to make sure I'm basically saying, yes, I received this message. You can get rid of it. Okay, so this is going to respond on post and it's going to respond on get. There's no routing that I need to give. Just slash is all the route that I need to give and I'm good to go. This code example, it actually has one line that I don't need, and that's the print payload. I only added that in there so that if you do deploy this, you can see something. And what you're going to see is the JSON that comes out of a MinIO event. And the MinIO event JSON is actually very robust. It's got lots of detail about the bucket that triggered it, the object that triggered it, all kinds of good stuff there. So just something to keep in mind. Actually, real quick, let's see that Flask demo in action. I actually have the code right here. If I do a cat of demo.py, there it is. This is the same code you just saw. So it's this Flask import. I am importing Flask and request and JSONify so that I can actually work with it. It's the same exact code. I am going to get my JSON request. I'm going to print the payload and then I'm going to return. Okay, that's it. I'm running this on port 7203. Don't worry about it. It's just a random port that I had open. So let's go ahead and run this. We run this with Python 3 demo py. And now I have this Flask app demo running here, and I've got it running on port 7203. Recall that I had set up a destination before. So what I need to do now is I need to actually set up a bucket, and I need to put an event on it. So let me go ahead and do that for you. So the first thing I need to do is I need to create a bucket, right? Because that's the simplest thing. I'm creating my bucket here. It's MinIO 1 events. And then I'm going to set up an event on this bucket. And I'm going to do that with an MC event add MinIO 1 events. And I'm going to use arn MinIO SQS, right? So that's the resource name. MinIO, simple queue service, and it's service webhook. And I'm going to watch events, just put events. Okay, so filtering this just on event, I'm just going to look for puts. There we go, and I've successfully added it. By the way, I can also do an MC event list on MinIO 1 events and see the various events that I have available. Okay, so there it is. Anything that's any object created event is going to trigger this code. So let's do an MC CP, and we will copy our sample text up there to MinIO 1 events. I don't see anything here. That's fine because it's not here that I want to see it. If I click back over to my Python window, though, there is my event. Event name S3 object created put. This is JSON, okay? And this is the JSON that I have read from my event. It's the events sample text is my key. So that's the bucket and the object name. So I could actually use that directly to retrieve this. I have a single record on this event that has a lot of different information to it, the event time, for instance. But key here is further down the list, I can see the bucket name. I can also see the object key, and this would allow me to go back and get more details about this. But this is just a very simple example that shows me what I can actually get out of an event, right? By the way, if you ever want to see just how events are working, you could just say, you know, any event that happens on this particular bucket, go ahead and show it to me, right? That would be something that I might want to look at as well. So there's our very simple demonstration code of a Flask service. In the final video in this series, we're going to take a look at how we can use Python to make this do even more for us. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also chat with us interactively on slack.min.io or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.